Hi, welcome to Cycling Vancouver. My name is Steve. I'm a 57-year-old guy, 6'5", around 250 pounds, who enjoys hockey, UFC, lots of baked goods, and cycling around the city. If you're interested in seeing what Vancouver looks like from the back of a road bike ridden by some old dude, sit back and relax. This is Ride 191. Today is Saturday, August 20th, 2022, and it's another hot, sunny day. The temperature was about 26 degrees Celsius when I set out at 2 p.m. for an epic ride. Normally, I don't like riding in hot weather, but I have no choice. This is going to be a long ride, and if I don't leave now, it'll be dark when I return. But first things first, I need to get out of the downtown core, and I expect this to be the most dangerous part of my ride. I think people feel summer is coming to an end soon, and they better get out now and enjoy it. I just want to get out of here safely. A few epic rides coming up over the next several weeks, and decided I better get out now and experience a long ride before I join a much larger group of riders. So I'm heading out east to New Westminster and crossing south over the Fraser River into Queensborough. I intend to explore that area before riding west through parts of Richmond and then crossing back north over the river and back downtown. I have never ridden through Queensborough or Richmond before, and I'm not absolutely certain about the route. It should be a bit like riding by Braille. But to make it even more fun, I'm first gonna head west to the University of British Columbia and perhaps visit a couple of beaches along the way. I measured out this route with Google Maps and I estimate the length to be about 100 kilometers. Much of it will be flat, especially once I get to the Richmond area, and that'll be quite the contrast to the next three rides I have lined up over the next several weeks. If I can't survive this one, then I'm in real trouble. Nice catch. Her throw was pretty good too. Now I'm gonna head south and visit Fraser River Park before starting the journey east to New West. time to work my way north to 45th Avenue and then east to Central Park. I stopped for a break by the school. I'm feeling tired already, but I still have a long way to ride. And it's pretty hot out. Cheers. It's blackberry season, and the air is ripe with the sweet blackberry scent. And now I'm suddenly craving pie. Perhaps later, I guess, but I do have some hermit cookies with me. Those will have to suffice. Andrea and I visited this area a couple of weeks ago to look at a condo in that tower. The layout was nice, 1,100 odd square feet with a great view south over the river. The resort-like amenities were awesome. A pool, an incredible weight room, a hot tub, and a steam room. But it's in the middle of nowhere and only $1.4 million. Thanks, but no. Property prices here are brutal. don't know my way around here. I looked at Google Maps and I want to find River Road. It starts somewhere west of Tree Island Industries, so I just need to find that and I should be good from there. I found Tree Island. River Road should be near. I think this is the worst bike lane I have ever encountered. What a joke. I turned onto that path, hoping it would be paved. It wasn't, and I want it out of here quickly. Now I just need to follow this road west and hopefully find the bike lane onto the SkyTrain bridge. I found the bridge and the bike path. That was easy. Now, time to cross north over to Ontario Street and head back into the city. Thank you. This was a really tough ride. Much harder than I anticipated, and that's without much climbing. I stopped 3 times along the way for a rest, and I got home by 8. All I want to do now is sleep. I am so going to die on next week's epic 100-kilometer ride.